to the cockpit of my F-16. Today, we are heading up the French coast, and we will be heading north and landing in Manston. That's the plan. I am completely new to this plane, but I have generally found my way around it. Today, there will be no firing of weapons, machine guns, or anything like that. It will simply be a trip up the coast and a landing. Now, stay with me, because this is a journey, and I'm going to learn how to fly this thing. And it looks very, very complicated. Anyway, so let's look at the outside of my plane. There's me in the cockpit, waiting. Right, let's go through a few checks. Left, right, left, right. Up, down, forward, back, rudder, right, left, right, left, center. Pre-flight checks look good. Brakes on. Let's power up the engine, let the brakes off, and then off we go. Gear up, up the coast, and let's go to Manston. Get in, come on. There we go, full power. knots, 150 knots, 160 knots, 170, 180, coming up to 200. Pull back on the stick before the end. There we go. Let's have a look. We're up in the air. Gear up. Let's just see how that looks. Here I come. Burner on. Let's get some height. What I'm trying to do is not use too much fuel, as you can see, because I'm low. I'm using a lot of fuel at the moment. So we're going to just pull back on the stick, give us a bit more elevation. Let's have a look at what we look like on the outside. And we look pretty bloody good. Get her under control. Beautiful, 17,000 feet. Let's pull her to a big climb here now. 18,000 feet, 19,000 feet. Speed dropping, 20,000 feet. Let's have a look. Here we go. Isn't that beautiful? Whoa, there we go. Condensation trail, 27,000 feet, 28,000 feet. Right, I'm gonna level her off now. Bring the fuel flow back. Bit of negative G, slowly. It can be quite an unpleasant experience for pilots, negative G. That's it. Let's have a look outside. Now we need to get our bearings and find out where we are. So we're at 34,000 feet. I'm going to put the automatic pilot on just to find out what's going on. Let's just turn it and head up to the coast a bit. Follow the French coast. There we go. Lost a bit of height there, 32,000 feet. What we're going to do now is we're going to put on the automatic pilot. And there she goes, altitude hold, 32,000 feet. Going to look across the water for Britain. Let's have a quick peek. Bring back. That's it. Bring back the throttles. Put them to around about idle, 2,200. So I'm going to put into a little dive just to get some more speed up. So turn the automatic pilot off for a second. What I want to do is I want to get the speed up to about 350, 400. Still can't see United Kingdom just yet. Such a beautiful plane to fly. All right. I'm dropping a lot of speed, a lot of height at the moment. So let's just put a bit more fuel in. We've got enough to mess around with at the moment. Let's get some proper speed up. There we go. Nice. 400. Coming up to 450. 24,000 feet. Let's make it around about 25. Come on, lad. Okay. Let's leave it at 25,000 feet and autopilot on. Yep. All right. You see there, it should hover around 25,800, somewhere around there. Right, gives us a good chance to have a quick look around. Right, there's the River Seine heading up towards Paris, which is over in that direction. Any traffic around? Don't see anything. That's good. Okay, let's throttle off now. Got quite a lot of speed. This is our fuel gauge. And we have to look at it all the time, really, just to find out that we're not going to be running out of fuel, which I have done. But I'm not going to do that today. Who said France is never beautiful? Look at it. Just amazing patchwork of fields and loveliness. Beautiful country. Beautiful. Okay, so let's have a look at where we are in the bigger scheme of things. Still can't see the United Kingdom. Let's zoom in. Definitely not. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to look at the F10 button and we're going to check out where exactly we are. Right, we've still got a fair bit to go. Now, I could turn directly north here and that'll bring me straight up to the UK. But what I want to do is I want to head up to Inlet past St. Aubin towards Abbeville. And then what we'll do is once we hit that inlet, we will take a straight north up the coast and head to the United Kingdom. Okay, let's get back to it. Speed 335, let's put some a bit more fuel up to get the speed up a bit. Otherwise we're going to be here all day. And if you got it, you flaunt it, right? So I've been learning about the heads-up display and it's pretty amazing. Canopy is superb. No canopy above your head. Vision in this thing is just fantastic. Look at that. Full complement of weapons, which I don't actually need at the moment. But yeah, you've got pretty unrestricted views in this thing. Unlike all the other planes, some of them have a big wide arch in front of your eyes, which I'm not madly keen on. Okay, we're coming up the coast. I can see the coast in the distance. Yeah, and what we're going to do is going to aim for that inlet over there. Good thing about being so high is you really get to see things in perspective. Okay, I'm going to bring it to a slow roll here now. Come back. We've still got the automatic pilot on. And it looks like it's compensating. That's it. Lovely. Beautiful. Let's see if the automatic pilot compensates for that now. Still using a lot of fuel. Let's look at our fuel gauge, which is here. We're doing all right. I've got the throttles on max. Let's have a quick peek at behind. China still. Probably don't need to be at this point in time. Throttle back a little bit. Don't I look pretty cool today? Fabulous. What a beautiful aircraft this thing is. Back in the cockpit. Left-hand turn. Back on the stick. Got enough momentum. 300, well, call it 400. Gonna just head a north up the coast. That's it. Come on, don't lose too much altitude. Lovely. Bit more power. I'm gonna keep her at 400. And there is our first sight of the United Kingdom. Yay. Autopilot's kicking in, bringing me back to 25,800, I think. Yeah, beautiful. What a piece of kit. All right, you can't see it from here. We'll look out the window. There's the United Kingdom. There's probably the White Cliffs of Dover in the distance. And Manston would be somewhere over there. Let's go back into the cockpit. So what we're going to do now is we're going to turn the autopilot off. Take control of the aircraft again. Slow roll to the right. And head right towards that piece of the United Kingdom there where it says where the fives are. Yeah. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into a slow dive. Bring the fuel flow down because we don't need full afterburner for this. We've got loads of speed. So what I'm going to do is try and end up down the end of the United Kingdom with a lot of speed, keeping the speed up by doing a dive, coming down by what, 5 degrees? Let's keep it at 5 degrees and see if we can keep it down there. Now I can turn the attitude. I don't know how to do that just yet, but I am getting there. So all you professionals out there who fly the F-16, don't be giving me a hard time, right? And that should be Dover. Let's see how where we're at the moment. So let's turn the F-10 menu on. And there's our destination, Manston. As you can see, the land sticks out a little bit and it's over in that little piece over there. Sticks out is where Manston is. Now Manston is a perfect runway for beginners because it's really, really long and it's really, really wide. So what I'm going to aim to do is keep the speed up around about 500, and once I get past the White Cliffs of Dover here, I'm going to make a very large bank over the sea and then come in by that promontory over there. You see that little beach? Right, the runway is just to the right of that. I think you might be able to just see it. So there you go, there's the White Cliffs of Dover, and there is Dover. Over the White Cliffs of Dover. The beautiful UK. Now I begin to see there's Manston there, right? Let's get back. Let's get back to the flight. Flight checks, 6,000 feet, coming down to 5,000. Let's throttle back a little bit. I want to lose a bit of speed now. We've got 558. Bring it down 6,000 feet. We're trying to level off around about 5. Going to bring it into a slow turn, also lose a bit of speed as well. All right, let's go. Nice slow turn. Back on the stick, gaining a bit of height. Let's move that down a touch. That's it, we want to try and keep it. That's it, beautiful. And we'll straighten up. The aim is not to lose too much height in a turn, and at the same time not lose too much speed. I'm throttling right back now. I want to lose all this momentum, because I want to get into an approach, and there's Manson Airfield there. Fantastic. Right, I want to come in over the town. That's my waypoint as such. Let's have a quick peek where we are. Yeah, beautiful, look at that. Just need to turn into Manson now, and we should be good. What we're going to do is we're going to turn right and come in on an alternative loop, lose a bit of speed, and see how we go. So let's turn right and come down, lose a bit of height, pull back on the stick. Pulling a lot of G's at the moment, but we are big and we are strong, and we can do that. Okay, so here we go. Always a dodgy time for pilots landing. Bring the engines back to idle. That's it. Bring it down a touch. Still going a bit fast. Obviously too fast for a landing. If we try and gain a bit of height, maybe we can chuck her down. Far too fast at the moment. Let's put the air brakes on. That's it, air brakes on. Let's see how we're going now with the air brakes. That's slowing us down. Superb, come on. Wheels down. Wheels down. Okay, 245, 230. Might be a little bit too fast, but let's see how we go. Try to keep the old girl level. That's it. That's it. Up we come. Bring the nose up. That's beautiful. Oh. We are down. Brakes on. Brakes on. Brakes on. Try and kick it straight with the rudder. Don't put the wheel brake on yet. Let's see what we're looking at on the outside. We're looking good. We haven't burst any tyres yet, which is something I have been doing recently. Landing far too hard. And we have come to a stop. Yeah, oh, nice one. So let's get to one of the side of the runway so we can just, let's put the nose wheel on. Here we go, there it is. Okay, bit of power. Not too much. She's a very sensitive little beast, this one. Best to keep her as slow as you can when you're doing taxiing. As you can see, I haven't quite mastered it yet. What we're going to do is we're going to turn off the runway in a second, and we're just going to park it up. All right. And that will be our show for the day. Here we go. Oh, Stacey, on the grass. Let's see if we can keep it straight up here. On the brakes. Nose wheel on. Let's see if we can just turn left onto the runway.